It was boredom at first sight. You could hardly call him bright. He is no one's Mr. Right. So what do I see in him? But then I'm not so ideal. I'm not gentle or genteel. So the question should be, what does
Sorry I'm late.
No problem. I had a lot on today.
I'm not inconveniencing you, am I?
No, no. I like to be inconvenienced.
You do?
Yeah, but well, I don't mind. Are you?
Certainly a beauty. You can tell she's been restored by a loving hand.
Do you like bikes, then?
Cars are sort of reserved, but bikes, well, especially the old ones, it's all there, isn't it? All exposed.
Thought of it like that before.
Well, you're spoiled handling them all the time. What about mine?
Yours?
My car.
Oh, yes, I'll have a look. It's probably something quite small. These occasional faults usually are. The trouble with yours is it's difficult to get at your primary side.
Oh, sweet. So you'll have to hang on to it, will you?
Desperately. I mean, definitely. Is that all right?
As long as it takes.
Right.
Will you run me home?
Yeah, well, it won't take long.
Will I watch, if you don't mind?
Right.
Yours all right?
Horrible.
I thought you were getting fish.
I did, but it was tasteless, so we swapped it for Malcolm's pie. Yeah.
You should have got curry.
I've only got one stomach. I was thinking of holding onto it for a bit.
Are you in a mood?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Do you find Egbeth a boring dump?
Yes.
And are you fed up being stuck in all day with no money?
Yes.
Is that why you're in the mood?
Shut up.
Hi.
Oh.
Where have you been?
Work. One of us has to.
Shut up.
She's in the mood.
I'm not. Where have you been?
I just told you, work.
Well, you weren't there an hour ago. I phoned to see if you wanted pie or fish.
Oh, yeah. I had to call somewhere on the way home.
Where?
Me mother's.
And did you eat there?
No.
You wish you had.
Shut up.
See? No, I didn't. I told you, honest. I just called. In the car.
Car?
It's outside. Thought we might go for a run later.
You bought a car?
Oh, no, no.
You nicked it?
No. No, it's a customer's. It's got a fault. I need to run it round a bit to Tracy.
What, and he believed you?
It's true. She, actually.
She?
Yeah, I remember that Lucinda was at Pam's last week.
Oh, where? Well, she'd probably be good for a few quid.
Thought we might go through to Southport.
Oh, yeah, smashing.
Oh.
Yeah, this great pub I know just outside Birkdale.
I didn't mean that all...
Now, you get your nosh, Malk. Brenda can square up here and I'll just...
Hang around doing nothing.
I told you she's in a mood.
I'm not. It's in the oven. It'll need warming up.
I'm sorry about him. I'd meant just us two.
Never mind. We can sit him in the back with a bottle and a colouring book.
Right.
Hey, by the way, there's a bit missing from your fish. I checked it just to make sure it was good enough for you.
That was kind.
You heating it up? Malk, you did remember to take it off the paper, didn't you?
You see, I can't really get comfy in the back of a car this size. It's my bad leg.
No, you had a bad leg. Which one is it?
One of these two.
it, you reckon?
Oh, about 20 miles.
And how far have we come?
About 1.5.
It'll be worth it.
Oh, it's a great pub. The beer is just superb.
Well, I know one that's got a slight advantage over yours.
Get away.
We could walk to it from here.
What about the beer?
Well, that's probably best described as disgusting.
You mean the grapes?
You know it?
Well, I've heard about it. Of course, it might have changed.
We could check it out. Much longer!
No, I've found the, I just need to...
How long?
Well, perhaps a few more, Well, no more than 10, certainly no more than a quarter. I've got to put the...
We'll be in the grapes. Come on. Hey, I can introduce you to Harold.
Oh, yeah?
The man who's done for bartending what Sweeney Todd's done for hairdressing.
Hey, before you go, just pass me...
That's Banner.
So this is where you first met him, eh?
Yeah. It's got a lot to answer for. I was sitting in here with our Pam doing a bit of people watching when he walks in. I thought he was a biker.
Our Malcolm, a biker?
Yeah, but when it comes to stupid, I've got medals. His leathers looked like offcuts from a worn-out sofa. No studs, no earrings, no wrist chains. In fact, nothing manly at all. And what I thought was a tattoo poking out from under his cuff turns out to be a borrowed phone number.
It's French.
It's vandalism.
It's French for grape. Is it French? No, no, that's prunes.
Well, it's all bloody rhubarb to me.
Well, maybe the beer's improved.
Not if that striped T-shirt's wrapped around what I think it's wrapped around.
Genuine Scouse comics?
Yes! And you keep the change, Harold?
Oh, thanks, love. By the way, it's not Harold. It's Pierre.
Pierre?
Oui.
Huh? Pouvons-nous avoir un pint et un demi de bitter, s'il vous plaît?
You what?
Pint of bitter, please.
All right.
Been murder yesterday. Murder. Two staff shots. Hey, and the cook's gone bolshy.
The cook?
Oh, yeah. We share food here now. Very continental.
Like what?
Spanish omelette. Hamburger and French fries. Cheers.
Good luck.
Well, I'm not looking forward to me second. Wow, look at this. I'd sooner not, if you don't mind.
You wouldn't believe it's the same place.
You will when you taste the ale.
Right, now, what are you having, Malcolm?
Oh, wine and soda, please.
Right.
Hey, there's a hell of a row going on outside.
Yeah?
Yeah, he's walking up there, there's a whole crowd of people screaming jokes at this bloke with a Walkman.
Strange.
Here, Malcolm, what do you want? A Bordeaux, Muscadet or Cheshire?
Cheshire?
Right.
No, what is it? Homebrew?
Oh, yes, yes, he grows his own grapes. He's got a glass house in Widnes.
Bordeaux, please.
Right.
It'll be another one of his funnies, you know.
Who, Harold's?
Bernard.
Oh, right.
I mean, he's all right in small doses, but I'm stuck with him all day. He can be a right pain, these people who won't take anything seriously. They're always coming back with the one-liners.
Oh, you think so?
It's true. So how'd you get on?
Oh, I've cracked it.
That's your own fault for bouncing her on the pavement.
Yeah, a right pain.
Yeah, well, I'm different. How'd you get on with Lucinda's car?
Oh, all right. Well, I guess it was something electrical.
And was it?
Yeah, dry joint.
Didn't know she smoked.
Faulty soldering. I've fixed it for now. I'll do a proper job tomorrow.
Right, here we are.
Oh, hey, it's not one of his own brews, is it?
Oh, no, no, no. But they did sound very interesting. There is a red, a white and a day glow orange.
Go on.
Apparently the cook's uncle's got a vineyard near Sellafield.
Oh. Hey, did you say cook?
Yeah, they've gone continental. Why are you hungry?
I'm starving.
It's your own fault for setting fire to your dinner.
Do you two want anything?
Oh, no, thanks.
Don't think so. I seem to recognise the handwriting.
Hungarian goulash.
Oh, no, don't bother. I suppose you want me to bring it over.
Morning. Oh. Well, that was a good night, wasn't it?
Was it?
Well, the bit I remember was. And that was a great club.
Which one? The one where you said you were from the Vice Squad, or the one where you tried to get him free with your pension book?
It was me bus pass, actually. I suppose it was quite a thrill for you being out with two handsome men about town.
Oh, yeah. Especially as one kept falling asleep and the other kept falling over. It was a dreadful trip.
Yes, well, the floor was slippy.
On the pavement.
Well, you noticed it too, did you? Right, well, what's for breakfast?
No idea.
You're not still in a mood, are you?
No.
Oh, good. Pour us some cornflakes, will you, Brenda? I'll pour me own milk, eh?
See you tonight, Bernard.
Oh, God.
That'll keep you regular. You look tired.
Yeah, we didn't get in till late last night.
Gallivanting, I suppose. It's all right for her ladyship with no job to go to the next day. But she's no right to be leading you astray.
Wasn't her doing the leading. It was Bear. Bear?
Bear?
Yogi Bear.
Who?
A friend. It's his nickname.
Yes, well, I assume he wasn't actually on his christening certificate. I've not heard you mention him before.
Who?
Yogi Bear.
Oh, yeah, I think he's...
One of her crowd, I suppose. Oh, I hope you're not having them in the house. It's a respectable neighbourhood, remember. Even more so since Bernard moved out. I'm sure it's a mess.
What is?
The house. Does she clean it?
Of course.
I'll bet.
We all do.
All?
Both. The pair of us. We each do our share, and it's just as Peggy left it.
Well, I wouldn't be asking much. Yeah, I don't believe you, Malcolm. I know what you were like when you were here, the pair of you. I shall have to call round. Next thing I'll be vermin.
Mother.
I shall have a word with Peggy when she gets back. Oh, the disgrace of it, having to have the council dirt squad in.
Mother, don't exaggerate.
You forget Malcolm Stoneway. I've known you since you were born.
Well, that's not unusual with mothers, is it?
I know when you're telling fibs. I know that little tweaking round the mouth. Yeah, and those sideways looks. I'm not as soft as I'm cabbage looking. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if this Yogi Bear isn't using Peggy's house for some acid drop party.
Acid house, Mother.
There you are. You admit it.
Of a modern major general. I've information, vegetable, animal, and mineral.
you see, it was all happening behind the fans, so I had to have it out. Well, I mean, it should have been happening, but it wasn't, which is why she cut out. See, the trouble was, the spade to the Lucca terminal on the LT side was all gunged up, so sometimes it wasn't making. And then when you stopped, it made again. And there was just no way of knowing unless you waggled it about a bit while it was still warm.
Is that what you did?
Yeah. I fixed it temporarily and then resold it properly this morning. And then, tragedy.
What happened?
My soldering iron. Put it down on my butty box. I don't use it much. I go to my mum's for lunch these days.
So?
So?
So what's the damage?
Ruined. Went straight through the lid, plastic.
How much do I owe you?
Oh, nothing.
Don't be silly. It's your livelihood. What about materials?
OK, there was the solder.
How much?
5p.
And your labour?
Oh, 10p.
Oh, you're hopeless. Look, if I can't pay, can I at least give you something?
No, it's all right.
Please, a present. What do you need at this moment?
Nothing, really, except...
Yes?
I suppose I do need a new butty box.
Is that all? Look, let me take you to lunch sometime.
Mm, that'd be nice.
And perhaps tomorrow I'll pop by with something for you.
Great. Look, I mean, it doesn't have to be the same, but my last one was a Snoopy.
I'll run you back.
Yes, yes, Peggy. Well, I know you were never in any danger of being called house proud, but this is beyond a joke. There's now no question you should not have let them near the place. Peggy, we are talking Haversham standards here. No. Miss Haversham in Great Expectations. Not the wig and prop forward. I tell you, not a finger has been lifted. How do I... Because when I got your cleaner out, what did I find? A cobweb right across your crevice nozzle. Oh, don't you be making excuses for her. There's worse to come. That little harlot is two-timing my son. She's having men round. In the house when I got here. No, I didn't see him because he ran off. But I know it was a he because he left a fully loaded shaving implement in the bathroom. What's more, I'm pretty sure his name is Yogi Bear.
Thank you very much, Malcolm.
Where have you been?
In the hide.
Why?
Well, I was hiding from Marjorie.
She's been here?
Well, she nearly caught me, got out just in time.
But your face is all red.
Chapped. She caught me mid-shave. I've been out there all afternoon. I must say, she's done a very good job, though, don't you think? Maybe you could sign her up to come round weekly, save Brenda having to do it.
Oh, God, Brenda.
Yes, well, she went out at lunchtime.
Yeah, I know, she rang. I was supposed to pick her up on me way past the grapes, I forgot.
Oh, less raisins, eh? Boozy little madam.
She'll do her not when she sees this place. The idea of my mother cleaning here. Oh, I'll have to think of something.
Well, don't worry, Malcolm, we will.
I'll have to go.
All right. We'll have one for me.
Harold. Harold, have you seen... Harold? Harold? Pierre?
Oui, monsieur.
Have you seen Brenda?
You'll have to wait your turn, mate. She's only got one pair of hands.
Whose is the Andalusian chicken with Russian salad?
Brenda?
What, you?
Yeah.
We've run out of carrots, so you've got egg and chips.
What are you doing?
I'm taking trombone lessons. What's it look like?
But why?
Because Cedric had a vacancy.
Look, Brenda, you don't have to do this.
Yes, I do. At least until I find something better. I'm fed up of skivvying for you and the jolly grey giant.
But you don't do anything.
Well, that's besides the point. You two think I should, which is just as bad. Worse, in fact, because at least if I did do something, the place wouldn't be in such a mess.
Oh, well, look, I might be a bit soft, but well...
Oh, don't sell yourself short, Malk. It's more than a bit.
Brenda, you're skivvying here.
Yeah, but I'm getting paid pennies for it. And apart from that, at the end of the day, I can go home.
Oh, well, if that's what you want.
Don't give me permission, Malk.
No, I just meant...
Don't.
No, okay, look, we'll all muck in.
Well, you can wipe the tables if you like, but I don't think he'll pay yet.
I mean, at home, me, you and Bernard, we'll all do a share. I'll draw up a rota. In fact, yes, that's it. I've started.
So you'll finish?
Well, see, the reason I'm late is that I knocked off early.
Well, as excuses go, Mark, I've heard better. You could have said you got lost in the Mersey Tunnel.
No, with finishing early, I had time to go back home to Egbert. And we, Bernard and me, sort of cleared up the place a bit. Yeah, and I sort of realised that it wasn't right to sort of leave it all to you.
Sort of.
Right.
Even though you didn't know I had a job by then, sort of.
Well, you have now, so it's even more appropriate. What time did you finish?
10 minutes ago.
Oh, great. Let's go then.
You know, there's a funny thing, Malk, but sometimes when you're sort of telling me something, your mouth sort of tweaks and your eyes sort of flicker from side to side. I've often wondered what that sort of means.
You know, it's amazing how much you can do in just an hour.
It's a wonder you could get that Casanova at the choir stalls to do anything at all.
You just wait till you see.
Oh, hello, you two. Had a good day. What have you been up to, Brenda?
Me neck and egg and chips.
It's okay. She never gets a man who's been around here. I put everything back to normal.
Oh, no, I just told them to clean up.
Oh. Cleaned up, have you?
No. Sort of. Yeah,
but we're not very good at it.
I think I'll pin it up in the kitchen.
What?
The rota. Now, Bernard will be blue. I'll be red. You're yellow.
Listen, Malk, it's not working.
Yeah, well, it hasn't started yet. Now, this week you've got Monday, Thursday, and Tuesday and Friday.
Look, when you asked me to... Well, I said no because I wasn't ready. And here I am, doing everything I said I wouldn't.
No, hold on.
No, you hold on. Look, I told you I wasn't ready for the housey-housey bit like our Pam. And here I am in the middle of Noddy Land with a womble and a wet wally.
Hey, which one's which?
Have I fallen in a spell? Does he drown me in Chanel? Is he vibrant? Is he out? So what do I see in him? Am I dazzled by his style? Has he made my life worthwhile? Does he melt me with his smile? Don't make me laugh,